This is the OTB Network.
And welcome to this week's edition of Horses and Choruses. I'm Jean Wood. We've got a busy program for you, and we'll get right to it. We'll head to Churchill Downs for our first race. The Matt Wynn ran last Saturday at Churchill Downs for three-year-old sprinters. And let's head back to Saturday and the running of the Matt Wynn.
Off and running of the Matt Wynn. Chief Wynn is bobbled at the break. Quick start for Grand Survival, but he's got grit up the inside. That takes over El Nino. Flashing speed on the far outside. Chief What It Is rushing up into contention now. Skeleton Crew four off the pace, racing fifth, changing Weather the Gray next up the inside. And Deputy G and four back to Court Folly at the back of the pack, but he's got grit, has made an easy lead. He's cleared by a length. Chief What It is second. El Nino third by three to Skeleton Crew. Grand Survival now changing Weather up the inside. And behind that, Deputy G and five back to Court Folly, quarter 21 and 2 around the turn. They're blazing up front. He's got grit by a length. Chief What It Is in second. El Nino ranging up on the outside in third. Skeleton Crew closing ground in fourth, changing Weather fifth, and Grand Survival up the inside as they turn for home. Half and 44 and 4. He's got grit, digs into the rail. Lip comes out on He's Got Grit. El Nino trying to press on by, and changing Weather's closing ground down the center. Grand Survival up the inside. He's got grip, tough as nails, still there. Here comes changing Weather on the outside. Court Folly flying, changing Weather. Court Folly surging, changing Weather wins them that win by a head. Court Folly second, He's Got Grit was third, and the time was 1:09:04.
Changing Weather getting the victory into Robbie Alvarado, Saratoga maiden winner last summer. Not quite able to live up to the expectation following that nice performance in his career debut, but here gets the win by a head all out into the stretch. Five wide to pick up the victory at the expense of Court Folly, with He's Got Grit making his first start back since last fall's victory in the Cowden, showing his usual good early speed, but fading to finish third in the field of eight. The winner, Changing Weather, is a gray or roan son of Storm Boot from Behaving by Rubiano, bred in Florida by the Says Who Thoroughbreds and owned by Darley Stable, trained by Owen Hardy, and ridden to victory by Robbie Alvarado. Changing Weather covers the six furlongs of the Matt Wynn in 1:09:04. We're going to head to California now in a couple of stakes races from Hollywood Park, beginning on Saturday with the Lazaro Barrera Memorial. $150,000 grade two for three-year-olds. Let's head out to California now and the Barrera.
They're off. Northern Soldier and Remembering Star go to the front. Gazwan and Arson Squad are third and fourth. Quietly Go is at the rail in fifth. Then comes Jealous Prophet, and the early trailer is Hey Slick. Remembering Star, without really being sent up the backstretch, take charge now, and Remembering Star is two lengths in front of Northern Soldier in second. Gazwan and Quietly Go try for the same spot, and Gazwan's going to beat Quietly Go to that spot, and so he had to take up, and it cost him a couple of lengths. Then comes Jealous Prophet. He's fifth and about six lengths off the lead. Arson Squad at the half-mile pole of the Laz Barrera has about 13 lengths to make up, and Hey Slick is the trailer as they leave the backstretch. Remembering Star and Northern Soldier are 1-2, Remembering Star three furlongs from the wire and a length and a quarter in front. Northern Soldier is second by three lengths from Gazwan and Quietly Go at the rail. Arson Squad begins to gather momentum. He'll have to go four wide at the quarter pole. He's just outside of Jealous Prophet, and Hey Slick is the trailer, and Northern Soldier confronts Remembering Star. These two off the top of the turn, and Remembering Star still a neck in front. Northern Soldier is second. Arson Squad's gotta go. He's still seven lengths behind, and Northern Soldier has taken over the lead. It's Northern Soldier in front. Arson Squad is flying now, but he's only got about 100 yards to make up this ground. Northern Soldier, Arson Squad at the rail, Remembering Star, Northern Soldier. Northern Soldier beat Remembering Star. Arson Squad finished third, close for fourth.
Northern Soldier and Chance Rollins picking up the victory in from Northern California for this performance. A three-quarter length advantage at almost 10-1 over Remembering Star, with the favorite Arson Squad back in the third spot. A little bit of a dull performance from him. He's usually got a little bit more kick than he showed. He settled nicely off the rail, did make a wide bid, but couldn't do any better than the third spot. The winner, Northern Soldier, is a bay three-year-old son of Yankee Victor from Adorable Lydia by Carson City. Bred in Kentucky by Pegasus Stud and Ledgelands Limited, owned by eRacing.com and Wind River Stable. Trained by Brian Corner and driven to victory by Chance Rollins, Northern Soldier covers the 7 furlongs at Hollywood in 122-2. Next up, we'll go back to California in the running of the Grade 3 Will Rogers on the turf for three-year-olds. Let's head back to Hollywood, Sunday's running of the Will Rogers.
They're off. Corazon del Campeón and New Jersey Jeff go to the front. Stratham and Silvercrest away third and fourth. David Flores has a handful with Silvercrest trying to get him to back out and tuck in. Then comes Niagara Causeway, followed by Obrigado, and the early trailer is Corey County. Corazon del Campeón clears off to the backstretch, and he's tugging at Patrick Valenzuela, wants to open up. Corazon del Campeón now 2 lengths in front of New Jersey Jeff, who races in second. Stratham and Silvercrest are together third and fourth, and they're about 3 from the front-running Corazon del Campeón. Niagara Causeway and Obrigado have 5 lengths to make up, and Corey County's at the back of the pack as they head up the backstretch in the 66th running of the Will Rogers Stakes, and Corazon del Campeón is a half mile from home, and he's still a willing leader. Corazon del Campeón trying to win it right now, going into the far turn. He is 2 lengths in front of New Jersey Jeff, who continues to track in second. Stratham and Silvercrest are still third and fourth. They're now 4 lengths behind the front-running Corazon del Campeón, who's 3 in front to the quarter pole. Corey County is out of last place. He moves up in the orange, 7 off the lead. Then Niagara Causeway and Obrigado, and they run to the top of the stretch. Corazon del Campeón, the one to beat. He is 2 lengths in front of New Jersey Jeff, who comes after him in second. Now New Jersey Jeff takes over the lead. Stratham, Corey County is closing from the back of the pack. New Jersey Jeff at the rail goes Stratham, and Stratham has taken over the lead. New Jersey Jeff is second. It is Stratham in front. Stratham beat New Jersey Jeff by a half length. Obrigado finished third, and Corey County fourth.
Stratham picking up the win under David Cohen. A nice effort from just off the pace. He was a little bit aggressive in the early going, but settled down fairly nicely to win off by 3/4 from New Jersey Jeff, moving on to the turf with reasonable success, running second after stalking throughout. Rider Jose Valdivia did lose his whip inside of the 16th pole, which may have put him at a bit of a disadvantage. Obrigado finishing in the third spot with a rallying run. The winner, Stratham, an Irish-bred bay son of Mozart from Bean Island by a fleet, bred by Epona Bloodstock and owned by Jerry Jumgashin, trained by Tim Yatin and ridden to victory by David Cohen. Stratham covers the 1 mile on the Hollywood turf course in 134 flat. We're going to head back to New York now for a pair of stakes races at Belmont, beginning with Saturday's Grade 2 Peter Pan for the three-year-olds, $200,000 mile and an eighth. Let's head down to Belmont and the Peter Pan.
Off. He's an old salt, Lewis Michael and Sun River. They go out for the lead as they race up the chute. He's an old salt and Lewis Michael. Testimony now with the front runners. And on the outside, it's strong contenders. So 4 of them across the track with Sun River right behind racing in 5th. Really Indian is in 6th. Scanlon Song is at the rail in 7th. Ice and Lemon is 8th. And it's a gap of 4 lengths to the trailer, Harbor Ridge, in 9th. The opening quarter, 24 2/5 seconds. And in between horses, Lewis Michael leads by a neck. Strong contender on the outside, and he's an old salt at the rail. A gap of 2.5 lengths to a testimony. Then comes Scanlon Song. Sun River has been moved to the outside. Then comes Ice and Lemon, a really Indian, and Harbor Ridge still trails. Opening half mile in 48 seconds. Now they begin to move around the far turn. He's an old salt. is down on the inside, and alongside is Lewis Michael. Lewis Michael with a head in front. He's at Old Salt racing in second. Strong Contender is third. It's 2.5 lengths to Sun River and Testimony, then Scanlon Song. Three quarters in 1:12.3. And now He's an Old Salt has dropped out of it. It's Strong Contender and Lewis Michael and Sun River on the outside. Into the stretch. Lewis Michael is in front. Lewis Michael by 3 lengths. Strong Contender is under the whip. Sun River now kicking in on the outside. It's Lewis Michael trying to hold off Sun River. Lewis Michael, Sun River driving on the outside. Lewis Michael, Sun River, those two down on the line. Photo finish that goes to Sun River by a head. Lewis Michael second. Then it was Strong Contender, and He's an Old Salt.
Sun River picking up the victory from off the pace, a grinding win by a neck over a game Lewis Michael, who was headed at the top of the stretch by Strong Contender, but had plenty to fight back, did end up finishing a solid second at 13-1. Strong Contender, the second choice in the wagering at just under 5-2, showed good early speed, but came up a bit weak and finished third. The winner, Sun River, a dark bay or brown son of St. Bellotto from Goulash by Mary's Brook, a full brother to Champion Ashado, was bred in Kentucky by Aaron and Marie Jones and is owned by the breeder, trained by Todd Pletcher, and ridden to victory by Rafael Bejarano. It may well turn out that being excluded on graded earnings from the Kentucky Derby may be one of the best things to happen to this guy. He is now pointing for the Belmont Stakes. Sun River completes the mile and an eighth on the one turn at Belmont in 1:49.1. Going to head back to Belmont now in Sunday's running at the Grade 2 Shoevee for older fillies and mares. Let's head back to Belmont on the call of the Shoevee.
And off. Indian Vale bobbled just a bit at the start. She's racing in second right now behind Take the Tour. Take the Tour has the lead. Indian Vale on the outside, and Grecian Lover is at the rail. Then it's Belletto and Smuggler, and the five of them race up the backstretch with Longshot, Take the Tour in front here. Take the Tour in front by almost a length. Indian Vale on the outside, and Grecian Lover at the rail. It's a length to Smuggler and Belletto. The opening quarter went in 23.15, and Take the Tour is the leader here by a little more than a length. Indian Vale, Grecian Lover, right together. Smuggler has now advanced. Smuggler moving up from fourth. Belletto trails the field in fifth. And now they race around the far turn. And Take the Tour has the lead by 2 lengths. Smuggler has moved into second. Indian Vale is in between horses. Down on the inside is Grecian Lover. Then comes Belletto, who's beginning to pick up some ground on the far outside. The half mile went in 46.15. It's still Take the Tour. Take the Tour by a length and a half. Belletto on the outside of Smuggler. Then it's Grecian Lover, and Indian Vale has dropped back to last in the field of five as they come into the stretch. Three quarters went in 1:10.4, and Take the Tour is trying to take this field wire to wire, and she's in front here now by 3.5 lengths. Belletto in second. Smuggler is third. Take the Tour to win the Shoevee Handicap in impressive fashion. Won by 5. Belletto second. Smuggler was third.
Take Detour, a little bit of an upsetter in here. It's 6-1 off of 2 very good allowance wins, including a romping win last time out in the race that marked Belletto's return to the races. Here she gets to the lead, never looks back. 5.5 lengths, widening when asked over Belletto and Javier Castellano. Smuggler picking up the third spot, a bit of an improved effort from her seasonal debut last out. Quite disappointing in this field of only 5 was Indian Vale, who stumbled a little bit coming out of the start gate and never seemed to really get into the race in her return race off of a winter vacation. I would assume that she will probably return with a little bit better performance next out. The winner, Take the Tour, is a chestnut mare, a daughter of Tour d'Or from Cherry Flair by Mr. Washington, bred in Florida by Paul Muller and owned by Alice Muller, trained by David Fox and ridden to victory by Cornelio Velasquez. Take the Tour covers the mile at Belmont in 1:36.00. We're going to pause now for a brief message. When we return, we'll be taking a look at last week's stakes racing action from Pimlico. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're going to continue now at Pimlico, where on Friday they ran a host of stakes races, beginning with the Edina Springs Miss Preakness, a Grade 3 sprint for 3-year-old fillies. Let's head down to Pimlico and the Edina Springs Miss Preakness.
And they're off. Miss Lina Celestia Legend, very fast out of the starting gate. G City Gal moving through to the inside also there, and Press Camp is in contention. Wildcat Betty B moving through in between horses and a little tight. Now Ardmore Prospect will settle. Miss Lina broke with him, but drops to second to last, and My Lucky Free is the trailer ganging up. And there goes Wildcat Betty B with a quick move in between fillies up to take the lead. Press Camp tight to the inside second. On the outside, Ardmore Prospect shuffled out of there with Celestial Legend. All of a sudden, she's dropped back to last as Celestial Legend. Miss Lina on the far outside is My Lucky Free, and G City Gal is in between horses now, improving a spot or two, 3.5 to 4 lengths in the front. And so Wildcat Betty B has escaped the shuffle with the fillies behind her, opening up at the top of the lane. Wildcat Betty B committed to go on now. It opens 3 lengths on Press Camp up the inside second. Ardmore Prospect followed by G City Gal in fourth and under a drive. There's less than 3/16 to run, and it's Wildcat Betty B. Dominguez getting to work. Press Camp coming out after her. She's got 3 lengths to make up. Only a 60th of a mile to do it. She's not going to do it. Wildcat Betty B. Wildcat Betty B. holding sway. Wildcat Betty B. to win it by 2. Press Camp second. G City Gal is third. Tight for fourth, Ardmore Prospect or My Lucky Free on the outside.
Wildcat Betty B. and Ramon Dominguez, one of those riders with a big home field advantage, getting to the front and improving position to win by 2 over Press Camp, who rallied well to finish in the second spot. G City Gal from off the pace made a bit of a wide move after having been checked and finished third. The winner, Wildcat Betty B., is a chestnut daughter of Meadow Lake from number 1 short by Catawice, bred in Kentucky by Barry Becker and Judith Becker, known by Oasis Racing Stable Limited and trained by Jay Jones. Ridden to victory by Ramon Dominguez. Wildcat Betty B. covers the 6 furlongs in 1 minute and 10 seconds flat. Next up, we're moving to sprinters on the turf with the very one $75,000 turf sprint for fillies and mares. Let's head down to Pimlico and the very one.
And they're off as Seen and Vogue hopped in the air at the start. Gilded Gold Kiss Me Katie out for that early leader is Gabbiana, last year's winner, firing right up there with the pace as well, followed by Bright Gold in between horses. We have Terra's Touch out of the fence. Coming through is Wildberry, just 3 to 4 lengths off the lead. Drop back another to Caldera Peak, who's next in line as they race on for the fire turn. And in between horses, there's Tropical Snow, but 7 from the front is Seen in Vogue, is recovered but under a full ride back there, third to last position. Well back is Quick Fire. Quick Fire is at the fence, a dozen lengths in the front, and Halloween Fun is the trailer. They're at the top of the stretch, and Gilded Gold and Bright Gold on the outside. The Golden Ones hook up at the 360s mark, and on the inside, Gilded Gold trying to turn back Bright Gold. Kiss Me Katie running a big one from third, center of the track. Here comes Quick Fire, is firing on very late, but it's Gilded Gold and Bright Gold. They appear gone. Gilded Gold and Bright Gold, Gilded Gold out of the line, Gilded Gold and Javier Castellano. Bright Gold in the photo finish for second with Kiss Me Katie. It's tight for fourth as well, Wildberry.
Gilded Gold, yet another victory going short on the grass. This is her third consecutive victory. She closed from just off the pace to win the Giants Causeway at Keeneland last month, and here goes to the front and never looks back. Winning off by 2.5 lengths is the even money choice over Bright Gold, who finished behind her at Keeneland last time out. Kiss Me Katie finishing in the third spot. The winner, Gilded Gold, is a dark bay of brown mare, a daughter of Gilded Time from Gran Senorita by El Gran Senor. Bred in Kentucky by Roger Davenport and owned by Bobby Flay, Robert Masterson, and Barry Weisbord, trained by Alan Goldberg and ridden to victory by Javier Castellano, Gilded Gold runs the 5 furlongs on the Pimlico turf in 57-1. Next up, the Allaire DuPont Breeders' Cup Distaff, $200,000 Grade 3 for fillies and mares. Let's head back to Pimlico and the Allaire DuPont Distaff.
And they're off. Solid start.
Plata, Princess Polona in pool land. All out for that early lead. Here comes Dance Fee in the third. Now Plata going to be taken back there. Promenade Girl moves up in the clear on the outside, followed by In the Gold, who's already seven lengths from the front. Freels for Real racing to the back of the pack with Silmaril, and Josh's Madeline is last and about eight lengths from the leader now. As they move into that turn, six and a half furlongs to go. Rounding the turn, Princess Polona tugging along at a good pace out there. Princess Polona from pool land in second. Inside, Dance Fee is third. Not a lot of pace on up front there. Promenade Girl is a handy fourth on the outside. Plata has caught very wide. Now Joshua's Madeline has made progress from last position all the way up to fourth and just three and a half lengths off the lead as the pace seems a crawl. In the Gold is in between horses, also there in contention, four to five lengths on the front. Plata continues that wide journey. Freels for Real and Silmaril is last. They're well bunched into the far turn. So it's been an easy free run up front for Princess Polona around the far turn. Now she's going to try to sprint home. Princess Polona the leader. Joshua's Madeline and Pool Land taking runs two and three wide. Joshua's Madeline on the far outside. Pool Land is in between horses. They've just passed Princess Polona at the 5/16 mark. It's three back to In the Gold, who's next, and Dance Fee to the inside. They're at the top of the stretch with a quarter to go at Pimlico, and the stage is set for a Real battle here. Josh's Madeline and Pool Land out of the inside, giving your all. Pool Land at the 3/16 pole, going slightly better from Josh's Madeline. It's three lengths back, and In the Gold is third. They've got a furlong to go. Pool Land, but look at Josh's Madeline. She's determined on the outside. Josh's Madeline, Pool Land with a 16th to go. Pool Land and Garrett Gomez going for the line. It's going to be Pool Land to prevail.
Pool Land, this filly just keeps getting better and better. She's now 5 of 6 for her career. She won the Double Dog Dare most recently, that race at Keeneland, and here she runs very close to the early pace. She stalks Princess Polona's rather quick pace and takes the lead at about the three quarters and draws clear by a length over Josh's Madeline, who did a nice job after getting off to a bit of a slow start. In the Gold completes the order of the top three. The winner, Pool Land, is a chestnut filly, a daughter of Silver Deputy from Slough City Slicker by Slough City Slough, bred in Kentucky by Kingsway Farm and Winfield Farm and owned by Melnick Racing Stable, trained by Todd Pletcher, ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez. Pool Land runs the mile on the 16th at Pimlico in 1:42.3. Next up, the Grade 2 Black-Eyed Susan for three-year-old fillies. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the Black-Eyed Susan.
And they're off. And a sharp start for the favorite, She's an 11, joined by Smart and Pretty in Saratoga Drive. The three of them sorting out at a modest pace early. So it's going to be Smart and Pretty and Saratoga Drive. They're both racing well in hand at that first turn. In the meantime, She's an 11 is a comfortable third. Bagdaria down to the inside, pushing through from fourth and just two and a half lengths on the front. Gage is saving ground into the first turn. Regal Engagement is out there three or four wide past the 7-8 pole. And trailing the field is Crystal Current. 24-2 for the opening quarter. So well-relaxed, Smart and Pretty takes them for the backstretch run by Justin Eckwin, the Berto Arroyo Jr. Saratoga Drive is second, and Regal Engagement on the far outside has been up from third now. With the inside, Bagdaria is next. And She's an 11, lingers about 05 from the front, racing off the inside. Gage is second to last, and trailing the field is Crystal Current. With 4.5 furlongs to go in the Black-Eyed Susan Stakes. And Smart and Pretty still dictating terms by a half length. Saratoga Drive trying to keep mile pressure on. Regal Engagement third on the outside. Bagdaria gets a nudge to go on. Followed in between horses by Gage, who's trying to quicken up. And Gage's got a bit of run, it appears, just four lengths in the front. In the meantime, She's an 11 is full out at the 5/16 pole. She's wide and got to do a little better than that as they get to the top of the lane. Last is Crystal Current. They turn for home. Regal Engagement and Ramon Dominguez up to take the lead. Smart and Pretty battles on down to the inside, and Saratoga Drive is third. Gage is next in fourth. The inside is Bagdaria. They've got a furlong to go. And Smart and Pretty in the inside's not done with Regal Engagement. They're going to fight it out head to head and nose to nose in the Woodford Reserve Black-Eyed Susan Stakes. And Smart and Pretty and a drifting Regal Engagement. Smart and Pretty and Norberto Arroyo Jr. stole it from the start.
Legal Engagement getting the victory on the disqualification of Smart and Pretty, who did drift out at about the 16th pole, taking away the path of Legal Engagement. After having led from just about start to finish, Legal Engagement was making a bit of a bid at the time that that the front runner did drift out. Begdaria picking up the third spot with a stalking trip. Little disappointing in this field was She's an 11, who was a favorite in this field. She did show a little bit of early speed before backing out. She did have an excuse in that she was a bit wide. The winner, Regal Engagement, is a chestnut three-year-old daughter of Cat Thief from Prestera by 49er, bred in Kentucky by Helen C. Alexander and Stuart Armstrong, owned by Mark Spitzer and trained by Tommy Bush. Filly that had broken her maiden in New York over the wintertime runs her record to 3 for 7 lifetime. She won the Busher 2 races back. After that, she finished an okay second in the Cumley, but here now gets a Grade 2 victory to her credit. Regal Engagement under Ramon Dominguez, covering the mile and an eighth and 150 flat. Next up, the Grade 1 Pimlico Special. Unfortunately, a light field for this mile and 3/16 $500,000 event. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the special.
All in. And they're off in the Pimlico Special. Argentinian Invisor out well, but Wandering Boy is expected to show early speed. So it's Wandering Boy coming to a narrow lead, 3/4 of a length from Invisor second. West Virginia to the inside, and Harlington racing deep out as they pass us now. And last of all is We Can Seek. So headed to that first turn, Wandering Boy and Javier Castellano leading it by 3/4 of a length. But Ramon Dominguez and Invisor, the Argentinian, right there in second spot as they round the turn. The outside is Harlington in third, and West Virginia down to the fence in fourth. There's 2.5 off the lead, and We Can Seek trailing the field. The opening quarter, 24 flat. So it looks like it's going to be a dead even pace here for Wandering Boy, who takes him up the back stretch with 6 furlongs to go. Wandering Boy 3/4 of a length. Invasor gets a nudge to go on from the second spot. Harlington continues wide in third, and fourth is West Virginia, another 2 lengths back, and We Can Seek has now dropped about 6 lengths off the front running Wandering Boy. The pace has picked up, but only slightly for Wandering Boy, comfortable with no challenge yet. Invasor still chasing on the outside. West Virginia hustle along down to the fence. Harlington on the outside. And last of all is We Can Seek. Pretty much no change around the far turn. And Wandering Boy is going to try to sprint home now with 3 is to go. Wandering Boy. Invasor chasing on. Harlington, West Virginia is riding the fence, and West Virginia is coming with a run from second. West Virginia into second, but Wandering Boy turns for home. Hustled at the quarter pole by a length and 3/4 from West Virginia. Invasor in third, and Harlington fourth, and We Can Seek riding the fence. They're at the 360s. Wandering Boy doing just that, wandering a bit toward the center of the track. Invasor shoulder to shoulder now with West Virginia down to the inside. Invasor's coming back for more. Invasor down to the inside. Wandering Boy. Invasor down to the inside with a 16th mile left to come. Ramon Dominguez and Invasor, the Argentinian invasion in the Pimlico Special. Wandering Boy was second, and West Virginia was third.
Invasor getting the victory. Very impressive performance in his first North American race. He did ship to the U.S. from his native South America and spent a little bit of time in training in Florida with Kieran McLaughlin before heading over to Dubai, where he ran a solid fourth behind Discreet Cat in the UAE Derby. Being as he is a Southern Hemisphere three-year-old, he was eligible for that event, and he has now come to the United States and run a pretty good one. Kieran McLaughlin indicated that he put him in here just to try to get an idea of where he fit with some of the North American horses. He picks up the win on ducking into the inside to pick up the win over Wandering Boy, who did drift out a little bit in a late going. West Virginia, always a hard knocker, holds on and finishes third. A little disappointing in here was Harlington, was the second choice in the wagering. He was a bit wide, but off of a couple of very impressive efforts to start off his season, he does finish fourth in the field of five. The winner, Invasor, is a bay colt, a four-year-old on Northern Hemisphere time, a son of Candy Stripes from Quendam by Interpret, bred in Argentina by Harris Glossan and owned by Shadwell Stable, trained by Kieran McLaughlin, ridden to victory by Ramon Dominguez. Invasor covers the mile in 3/16 and 154 and 2. We're going to pause now for one more brief break, and when we return, we'll be taking a look at the stakes racing action from Preakness Day at Pimlico. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're going to continue now on Saturday at Pimlico, beginning with the Baltimore Breeders' Cup Turf Sprint. $100,000 dash on the grass. Let's head down to Pimlico and the Baltimore Breeders' Cup Turf Sprint.
And they're off. Southern Missile Spring Kitten, there goes Sarah's Prospect sent forward. Procreate and Private City are also in the early mix, and Southern Missile has been outsprinted by the very fast Sarah's Prospect, who rolls and scorches with a fire turn. All Hail Stormy, five lengths off the lead. Spring Kitten has settled. Abundanza racing to the back of the pack. Late running My Lord and second in command, trailing the field into the fire turn. Sarah's Prospect joined by Procreate on the outside. Procreate comes to even terms with Sarah's Prospect and going on to neck in front. Southern Missile has to rally from off the pace in third, and All Hail Stormy is fourth. Spring Kitten is running a big one from fifth, still a half dozen to close in. Then it's back to Abundanza in second in command. Into the stretch, just about a furlong to go. Procreate the leader, Southern Missile trying to gun that one down. Spring Kitten on the far outside, very much into it as well. Southern Missile, Spring Kitten rolling on the far outside. My Lord is picking up the pieces. Here comes My Lord, like a rocket on the outside. My Lord, My Lord! My Lord's got enough to win it under Rosie DeProvnik. Southern Missile and Spring Kitten.
My Lord, Rosie DeProvnik getting the victory, and she has been an absolute riding monster down there, winning a ton of races and here getting a nice stakes to her credentials from way back off the pace with a 7-wide bid by 3/4 of a length on My Lord at the expense of Southern Missile, who did look like he might have it sewn up. Spring Kitten, a solid effort to run in the third spot at 32-1. The winner, My Lord, is a chestnut gelded son of Lord Carson from Love of Our Life by Vice Regent, bred in California by Patricia Youngman and owned by David Ross. Trained by David Ross and ridden to victory by Rosie DeProvnik, My Lord covers the 5 furlongs at Pimlico on that turf course in 57-2. Next up, the Hirsch Jacobs for 3-year-old sprinters, a grade 3, $100,000, 6 furlongs. Let's head down to Pimlico and the Hirsch Jacobs.
Ready for the Hirsch Jacobs. In line. And they're off. Pagan Moon rockets out of there. Has beat Songster to the front, but Songster immediately on the attack, and it's Songster up to take the lead. Pagan Moon there in second, then it's We Missed You Nickel with the fence in third. Urban Guy chases on from fourth and 2 lengths off the lead of Songster. Another 2.5, and it's Valid Brush and trailing the field. Mike's Good and Tough. Racing on to the fiery turn now. Songster and Edgar Prado. Songster, the favorite, is cleared. Songster from Pagan Moon second. Now in third, the outside. Urban Guy racing in the clear. Urban Guy takes his best shot at Songster. Songster with 3 furlongs to go. We Miss You Nico and Valid Brush, and Mike's Good and Tough is the trailer. So they're midway on the turn, and a brisk pace set by Songster leads at 3/4 of a length. Urban Guy is second. Pagan Moon sticking with the pace in third to the inside as they pass the quarter pole. Back to Valid Brush, Mike's Good and Tough, and We Miss You Nico into the stretch, a furlong and a half from home, and Songster gets the cue to go on from Prado, and Songster suddenly takes off and takes off with authority with 1 furlong to go. Songster is bulleting home in the Hirsch Jacobs Stakes, leaving all the others in his wake. And look at Songster roll home with ease. Songster a peak right, and Songster wins with ears up in 109-3. It's a photo for second. Urban Guy in there with Valid Brush.
Songster absolutely romping. This guy broke his maiden very impressively in his career debut, has yet to win since that, but has managed to finish second in a pair of good stakes, including a solid second last time out in the Bayshore behind Too Much Bling. Here he gets to the front and wins off by 10, never looking back over Valid Brush and Urban Guy, who had run a couple of very good performances in a row leading into this one. The winner, Songster, a black son of Song and a Prayer from Pepe Le Pew by French Deputy, bred in Florida by Richard Jacopelli and owned by Darley Stable, trained by Tom Albertroni and ridden to victory by Edgar Prado. Songster covers the 6 furlongs at Pimlico in 109-3. Next up, the Grade 3 Gallerette for 3 and up fillies and mares going long on the grass. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the running of the Gallerette.
Rather 60-1, excuse me, and moving in, and they're off. And away in good order there. And a good break for Theatrics of Dance, and also My Typhoon away in good order, too. Queen Supreme is rushing forward with some early speed. Ernabelle is on the mix, so it's Queen Supreme and Ernabelle. My Typhoon well settled in the early stages in third. Humoristic on the far outside, racing in fourth. Then to the inside is Art Fan, who's racing fifth early. Miss Audrey is sixth and just five lengths off the lead. Followed by Smart and Classy, who's getting over to the two-path now, and it's Ozone Bear who's next in line. Another length and a half back to Laura Fina, and outside of that is Theatrics of Dance, followed by Feeling the Breeze and Trailing the Field back there. We have Topiary, and Topiary's got to be about 22 lengths off the lead. Down the backstretch in the firm going here, Queen Supreme three-quarters of a length. Humoristic is pressing in the second spot. The inside there is Ernabelle in third. My Typhoon well poised in fourth. The inside Art Fan is fifth, and Miss Audrey is in sixth. Ozone Bear is seventh and ground saving, and seven from the front. Followed by Smart and Classy length and a half to Laura Fina, who's next in line is around the far turn. Queen Supreme with Humoristic stalking well. Humoristic makes a bid for the lead. My Typhoon is ready to roll. And here she comes now, My Typhoon and Edgar Prado running toward the front with Humoristic. Humoristic and My Typhoon head and head for the lead. Art Fan swings into action, and Ozone Bear in the orange colors. That's a great trying to slip through and thread the needle down. There on the Ozone Bear gets through on the inside, and Ozone Bear is forging forward down toward the fence. Ozone Bear with some momentum to the inside. My Typhoon battles on. Humoristic far outside. There is also Art Fan. Art Fan on the far outside. Ozone Bear, Humoristic. Any one of three horses can win it. Ozone Bear, she's there and she's gonna win it. Ozone Bear, Ozone Bear to win it from Humoristic in a photo finish.
Ozone Bear making her American debut, a winning one. Very impressive performance with Javier Castellano finding a spot in between horses, getting to the rail and getting up by a head over Humoristic, who had a length advantage on Art Fan as they crossed the wire. My Typhoon in her first race back in quite some time set a perfect stalking trip under Edgar Prado as the favorite, but she did come up a little bit late and finished fourth in the full field of 13. The winner, Ozone Bear, a gray filly, a daughter of Verglas from Ajab al-Zaman by Rainbow Quest, was bred in France by SNC Regner and San Gabriel Investments, owned by Jean-Claude Seroul and trained by Christophe Clément. Winning the victory by Javier Castellano, Ozone Bear covers the mile in a 16th on the Pimlico turf in 1 minute 42 flat. Next up, the ungraded Sir Barton for three-year-olds, $100,000 mile in a 16th. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the Sir Barton.
Ultimate goal. All set. And they're off. Good start. Little Cliff, Sharp's Island, Ultimate Goal, and High Cotton all going for the early lead, and High Cotton grabs a narrow lead. Ultimate Goal is trying to get position with Prado from the outside. A hard-held Little Cliff wants no part of the paces. Javier Castellano has wrangled that one back into the third spot. Sharp's Island three wide, and here's the race favorite, Ade. Ade is eager in the early stages and tugging all the way up to third there to the inside. Ade third, a length and a quarter off of High Cotton. In the meantime, late running Vegas Play and Our Peak of the Trailers, and they're about eight lengths from the front, and the pace by High Cotton and Garrett Gomez up the backstretch. Ultimate Goal is second. Ade trying to settle down in the third spot, and Little Cliff racing in fourth. Sharp's Island, long shot of the far outside. Vegas Play has got six lengths to close in. Our Peak trailing the field. Six and a half to seven lengths will cover them. Four and a half furlongs to run on the Sir Barton. High Cotton making all the pace. Ultimate Goal second. Ade ground saving in third. Little Cliff is right there with a shot. Little Cliff is in the clear and bidding up outside. Little Cliff is under third spot now, and Ade all of a sudden under a ride. Ade is fourth inside, under a ride, has dropped three lengths in the front. Sharp's Island, then Vegas Play, and Our Peak is the trailer. They're at the 5/16. High Cotton, Ultimate Goal, turning up the pressure on the outside. Little Cliff is in third. Ade is under the whip at the top of the stretch as High Cotton and Garrett Gomez digging down for more as they turn for home. Ultimate Goal is second, Little Cliff third. Ade seems struggling in fourth, a furlong and a half from home, and it's High Cotton. High Cotton with another gear. High Cotton to the final furlong, trying to speed home now, and High Cotton's got it. High Cotton by a length of three quarters, two lengths. Ultimate Goal second. Into third is Little Cliff. Vegas Play on for a minor award. Ade never really fired. With a 16th to go, it's High Cotton coming home. High Cotton ridden out to victory in the Sir Barton by about four. Ultimate Goal was second. Third, Little Cliff. And then Vegas Play.
High Cotton and Garrett Gomez getting to the front and continuing on nicely by 5.5 lengths over Stablemate Ultimate Goal, with Little Cliff back in the third spot. High Cotton, disappointing ninth last time out in the Arkansas Derby after having won the rush away in his prior start. Here gets the advantage at the start and never looks back. His Stablemate Ultimate Goal, very lightly raced but well-bred individual, another one with quite a bit of upside potential. The winner, High Cotton, a bay three-year-old son of Dixie Union from Happy Tune by AP Indy, was bred in Kentucky by William S. Farish and Ogden Mills Phipps, won by the Peachtree Stable and trained by Todd Pletcher. Ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez, High Cotton covers the mile in the 16th in 1 minute 42 and 4. Next up, the Maryland Breeders' Cup Sprint, a grade 3 for older horses going short. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the Maryland Breeders' Cup.
In the gate. And they're off. And Kazoo intent for the early lead, but accompanied by Gaffin, Friendly Island in a three-way spirited duel early, and Kazoo slightly faster. Kazoo's going to go on with it, aggressively ridden to the front by a half length with five furlongs to go. Friendly Island, Gaff is now settled in third spot, followed by Crafty Schemer from the inside gate, guarding that rail. Crafty Schemer pushes in third, and Gaff in tight quarters, going to be shuffled out of there. Gaff in some trouble into the far turn. In the meantime, Celtic Innes has a free run on the far outside, advancing into fourth. Back to Better Than Bonds is about six off the lead. A late running Gold Cluster is the trailer. There's three aces to go. And it's Kazoo, three quarters of a length. Friendly Island turning up the pressure on the outside. Celtic Innes is next, followed by Crafty Schemer as they get to the quarter pole in the top of the stretch. Contested pace now as Kazoo's accompanied on the outside by Friendly Island. Friendly Island going on to a narrow lead. Celtic Innes is running a huge race on the far outside. In between horses, Gaff is trying to find some late kick. There's a furlong to go. And it's Friendly Island holding sway. Friendly Island in front. Celtic Innes on the outside. Gaff trying to surge on in between horses. Friendly Island holding on. Friendly Island, Garrett Gomez is going to get there. Celtic Innes was second and Gaff a troubled third.
Friendly Island, this is actually his first open stakes win. He's a very solid New York bred who's run a lot of real good races against good horses, but interestingly enough, had never won an open stakes company. Here goes off as the favorite, just under 2-1, and wins over Celtic Innes, who is very game at almost 25-1. Gaff, a little bit disappointing in his American return after having gone over to Dubai last time out, but he did end up getting pinched in traffic a little bit, had a couple of points where Alex Solis had to step on the brakes, so that may have cost him just a bit at the wire. The winner, Friendly Island, is a chestnut son of Crafty Friend from Island Queen by Ogaijin, bred in New York by Kildare Stud and Adrian Regan, owned by the Anstew Stable and trained by Todd Fletcher. Ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez, Friendly Island covers the six furlongs of the Maryland Breeders' Cup Sprint in 109 and 4. Next up, we're going to head to the turf in the Grade 2 Dixie. This is for older horses on the grass. Let's head back down to Pimlico, the running of the Dixie.
Artie Schiller. All in. And they're off. Shake the Bank bobbled slightly at the start, but nevertheless going to go out to the grab the early lead. Shake the Bank and also Dr. Detroit. So there's not a lot of pace on here, as Artie Schiller is also right out there on the crawl early. And a Rebel in between horses in fourth. Dreadnought is only 3-4 lengths off that lead, followed by Savory D'Argent and Better Talk Now trailing the field. Shake the Bank not really flying out there with Tommy Turner into the first turn. And Shake the Bank going a slow pace for the distance, length and a half. Favorite Artie Schiller tracks along in second. Getting away now a bit is Shake the Bank by three from Artie Schiller. Dr. Detroit is a well-settled third to the inside. Alongside of that is Rebel. Dreadnought has a couple horses beaten at this point. Saber D'Argent. And trailing the field is Better Talk Now. Better Talk Now is about seven lengths from his entry mate up front. Shake the Bank begins to quicken up that pace, so the run for the far turn. Shake the Bank leads it by three. Artie Schiller has the target in sight second. Rebel is in third position. Dr. Detroit racing down to the inside, followed by Dreadnought. Saber D'Argent cut a little bit wide for the far turn run. Better Talk Now, Better Start Running Now into the far turn. And Shake the Bank doing the easy work up front. Leads it by some three lengths. Shake the Bank. Let's see what he's got left. Artie Schiller now coming with a bold run from second. Rebel. roused on the outside for run. Dreadnought is next. Better Talk Now is cutting the corner, and here he comes. Better Talk Now to the inside. Into the stretch, Artie Schiller. Better Talk Now trying to forge through in between horses with a late burst of energy. The outside, Dreadnought is also right there. Artie Schiller, Dreadnought on the outside. Better Talk Now in between horses with some late foot. Final 16th of a mile. Dreadnought on the outside, Artie Schiller. And Better Talk Now rolling in between horses to grab it in time.
Better Talk Now, literally in the shadow of the wire, spinning horses, getting his nose down on the wire in front under Ramon Dominguez, with Dreadnought outside, Artie Schiller inside, in a three-horse blanket finish. The stablemate of Better Talk Now, Shake the Bank, did his thing, got out to the lead, but did not set a particularly fast pace after a stumbling start. Nonetheless, Better Talk Now still able to get the job done from last to first to win by a head over Dreadnought. The winner, Better Talk Now, often not giving him much credit as he deserves. He won the Breeders' Cup Turf in 04. He is a multiple Grade 1 winner, but for some reason does not seem to get the credit that he deserves. At the age of 7, this dark bay of brown gelded son of Talking Man from Bandita Balbalski continues to run very big events. He was bred in Kentucky by the Wimborne Farm and is owned by Bushwood Racing Partners, trained by Graham Motion, ridden to victory by Ramon Dominguez. Better Talk Now covers the mile and an eighth, distance a little bit shorter than his best, in 1:48.2. We're going to head right back to the main track now in the William Donald Schaefer, a Grade 3 for older horses, going a mile and an eighth. Let's head back down to Pimlico and the Schaefer.
6 to 5, Master Command, Funny Side, 9 to 5. All in. And they're off. Summer Book showing early foot with Master Command, the two inside gates, and Water Cannon away in third spot, followed by Funny Side, who's well settled in the early furlong here. The opening furlong, and it's Master Command leading the way. Now Funny Side going to be angled right to the rail there by Migliori into the first turn. Andromeda's Hero and trailing the field, the late running Play Bingo. So around that first turn, it's Master Command three quarters of a length. Summer Book is second. Funny Side is tugging in the third spot, just two lengths from the front. Funny Side wants to go on right now at the 6.5 furlong marker, but Migliori has got a firm hold of the 2003 Preakness winner. He's off the lead just a length and three quarters in the front, running Master Command. In the meantime, Water Cannon is in fourth position, another 2.5 lengths, and Andromeda's Hero and Play Bingo trailing the field. Fairly easy pace for this group with less than 5/8 to go. Master Command, Summer Book. Master Command, a neck to Summer Book. Funny Side still at the fence in third, wants to go on now. The foot in the dashboard, though, by Migliori on Funny Side. Maybe an opening on the inside. Let's see there. Looks like there's enough room for Funny Side to possibly sneak through there. But into the far turn, Master Command lets it out a notch. Summer Book on the outside, Andromeda's Hero suddenly swoops and loops him with three furlongs to go. And here's Andromeda's Hero right on the outside to take the lead at the 5/16 pole. Funny Side asks for run. No response there from Funny Side at the quarter pole. They're at the top of the stretch. Andromeda's Hero battling along with Master Command. They've opened up now. Third spot to Summer Book. Funny Side is in fourth at the 3/16, Andromeda's Hero. Master Command trying to battle back on the inside. Master Command's in for a fight with Andromeda's Hero with one furlong to go. Master Command, Garrett Gomez going to work. Garrett Gomez with four wins on the card. It's Master Command in command in the Schaefer. Master Command by 2.5. Andromeda's Hero, Funny Side checks in third. Close fourth with Play Bingo in the picture.
Master Command earning his first stakes victory, running his record to 4/8 lifetime with an impressive performance. Andromeda's Hero made a sweeping move outside of horses and appeared to be heading for what looked like it would have been a romping victory, but Master Command dug deep and turned back that challenge to draw clear by almost three lengths as the favorite over Andromeda's Hero. Funny Side, who had a little bit of a rough trip. Richie Migliori settled him inside of horses and never seemed to get him to relax. He was a little bit aggressive. He broke alertly when he was taken down inside. It did appear that he had a little bit of trouble restraining Funny Side, but Richie Migliori, when he asked him to go, he said he came up a little bit flat, but he did kick in to close once again. We rallied to finish third. The winner, Master Command, is a chestnut son of A.P. Indy from Lady Loch Navarre by Lord at War, bred in Pennsylvania by the Brushwood Stable and owned by Aaron and Marie Jones. Trained by Todd Pletcher, who had a wonderful day at Pimlico on Saturday and ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez. Master Command runs the mile and an eighth of the Schaefer in 1:49.2. Next up, of course, the Grade 1 Preakness, a $1 million mile and 3/16, the second leg of the Triple Crown. Let's head down to Pimlico in the running of the Preakness.
And they're off in the 131st Preakness. Garrett Gomez wants the lead. Like Now, and he's got it. Like Now, sprinting to the front from the inside post, Sweet Northern Saint, who is away in the second spot of the outside, Bernardini. A far outside is Diabolical, trying to get over to save some ground. Oh, Barbaro has pulled up in the opening furlong. Barbaro Rank has been pulled up into the turn. No Triple Crown winner this year. So into the first turn, it's Like Now at a relaxed pace by about a length and a quarter. Sweet Northern Saint, the second spot. A gap of two lengths, and Bernardini's racing third. Brother Derek on the far outside, racing in fourth. And Diabolical and Dominguez poised to the inside in fifth, racing well in hand off a fairly easy pace for Like Now. It's a break of about four or five lengths. Platinum Couple is next, and back to Hemingway's Key, and Grilly's Legacy, and Barbaro has been pulled up just before the first turn. As they race to the five turn now, 23-1, opening quarter, 46-3 for the half mile. Like Now, Kent DeSormo going to challenge now with Sweet Northern Saint on the outside. Garrett Gomez says, go on Like Now for more. Sweet Northern Saint on the outside. Brother Derek gets a nudge, but he's just off the inside and has to find a little more. Inside, Bernardini's running a big one, and Bernardini's firing big. Bernardini firing a bullet on the outside, and here he comes, three of them right across the track. In the meantime, Diabolical and Dominguez just six lengths off the lead. They're at the top of the stretch. Sweet Northern Saint, Bernardini, Like Now fades off the scene. Next is Brother Derek, who struggles along in the stretch of the 131st Preakness. And here comes Bernardini, and he's roaring and pouring it on. Bernardini, and higher there, Castellano goes to the left-handed stick, but he's well clear from Sweet Northern Saint and all the others. Hemingway's Key has moved into third. Bernardini in the Preakness to win Going Away by five. Sweet Northern Saint was second, Hemingway's Key, Brother Derek, followed by Greeley's Legacy and Platinum Couple, and Like Now and Diabolical.
Bernardini getting the victory, five and a half or five and a quarter official lengths, lugging in a little bit late, but he certainly was finishing up fairly strongly over Sweet Northern Saint, who according to reports did grab a quarter coming out of the gate, but nonetheless ran a very big race to run second. Hemingway's Key plunking up to finish third at about 30-1. Of course, this race marred by the breakdown of Barbaro, the Kentucky Derby winner who was unbeaten going into this race, and obviously a very much tragic event. It has been much written about and much publicized in the mainstream media. Barbaro obviously fighting for his life at this moment in a clinic at the New Bolton Center in Pennsylvania after having suffered multiple fractures in his right hind ankle area. So obviously an unfortunate turn of events, and I'm certain that the connections, all of the connections of Bernardini and the other horses in this race, continue to extend their condolences and hope for a full recovery for the Kentucky Derby winner after this rather tragic event. The winner, Bernardini, however, does look like a very impressive youngster. His fourth lifetime start, his first try around two turns, picking up $1 million Grade One, and I presume that he will head into the Belmont Stakes off of this impressive performance. Bernardini, a Bay 3-year-old son of AP Indy from Cara Raffaella by Quiet American, bred in Kentucky by Darley and owned by Darley Stable, trained by Tom Albertrani, ridden to victory by Javier Castellano. And a lot of people for many years have believed that AP Indy was destined to sire a classic winner. He finally gets his classic winner, but unfortunately in a race marred by tragedy. Bernardini, ridden to victory by Javier Castellano, covers the mile in 3/16 of the Preakness in 1:54.3. That'll wrap up this week's busy edition of Horses and Courses. Thank you very much for joining us. We hope you'll be able to join us next week as we take a look at stakes racing action from around the country. Until then, I'm Jean Wood. Have a great week at the races.